welcome you, boys and girls, to this session on viscosity. Viscosity is actually the opposing force to the flow of a liquid. It is the characteristic property of each and every liquid. You know that honey is more viscous than water. Water is more viscous than gasoline, petrol, diesel. And viscosity, as you already said, is the opposing force to the flow of a liquid. And to understand what is viscosity and viscosity coefficient or coefficient of viscosity, let us consider actually how a liquid flows. It is assumed that there are so many layers when a liquid is flowing. The bottommost layer, which is in contact with the ground, the molecules here are supposed to be stationary. Whereas the top layer over the bottom layer tries to forge ahead. And the next layer tries to forge a little more ahead. And now, if the distance between these layers is z, and if you consider any intermediate layer, its velocity is increased by or accelerated by top layer, and it is decelerated by bottom layer, and the velocity gradient is given by du by dz. Z is the distance. U is the velocity, du is change in velocity, and du by dz gives the what is called as velocity gradient. Now the force required to maintain the flow of a liquid, to overcome the opposition to the flow of a liquid, you require a kind of force to maintain the flow. This force is directly proportional to velocity gradient. This force is also required to maintain the flow is proportional to area of contact. More is the area of contact, you require more push. Now the force that sustains the flow of a liquid is directly proportional to A into concentration gradient, the velocity gradient. And now, therefore, to remove the proportionality, I put a constant called eta. F is equal to eta into A into du by dz. This eta is actually the force required to maintain the flow of a liquid, or it is exactly equal to opposing force. Unless you overcome the opposing force to the flow of a liquid, you can't maintain the flow. Therefore, this force experienced by a liquid to sustain its force of flow when the area of contact is unity, when the velocity gradient is also unity. Now the viscosity coefficient has units of force divided by area divided by the velocity gradient. It works out to be unit of force is Newton. When A is coming this side, Newton per meter square second per meter square is the unit of viscosity. And now this can also be written as kg meter inverse per second. This is also unit of viscosity coefficient. Now viscosity coefficient depends on the type of intermolecular forces a liquid has, hydrogen bonds or else strong van der Waal attractions, they are all increasing the viscosity. A rise in temperature will decrease the velocity, viscosity. If the viscosity is decreased, the liquid can flow more easier. So if you take hot water and cool water, which water do you think flows faster? Obviously, hot water flows much faster, right? And now, in good olden days, the viscosity was measured. Instead of nowadays, we are saying kg meter inverse per second is SI unit. In good olden days, it was measured in grams per centimeter per second. It is called one poise in honor of a scientist who worked on in this field. And one poise is equal to 10 to the power minus 1 kg meter inverse per second. This is the conversion therein. And now, greater the viscosity, more slowly the liquid flows. In water, viscosity is higher than that of gasoline because of intermolecular forces called hydrogen bonds. Do you know that glass is in fact a highly viscous liquid? So there is a very strong opposing force to the flow of glass. Nevertheless, glass flows very slowly. If you go to a very old building, like if you visit Taj Mahal in India, where it is located in Agra, if you look at the window panes in the top place, the windows will be thicker in the bottom, the glass. It means over a period of time the glass has flown. Therefore, bottom became thicker, top became thinner. In all old buildings you can see this, because glass is actually a super cool, highly viscous liquid that flows very slowly. So this is a discussion on viscosity. Thank you very much.